Hello everyone, welcome to Lesson 38, Everything Except the Weather. 大家好，今天呢我们学习第38课 Everything Except the Weather, 唯独没有考虑到天气。This story is about a man named Harrison who had always wanted to live in England. 故事呢讲的是一位名叫 Harrison 的男子，他呢退休以后想到英格兰居住。这么一个故事。好，我们先看看 keywords and expressions。Harrison, the Mediterranean, retire, settle down, complain, continually.Bitterly cold. Get a shock. As if. In the end. Okay, that's it for keywords and expressions. As usual, before you look at the flash, I would like you to keep the following questions in mind. 好，在大家看动漫之前呢想让大家先看看这几个问题，并且考虑一下怎么回答他们。我们一起来看一下。
Where had Harrison spent many years before he returned to England?
Harrison 在回到英国之前，在哪儿住了多年
？What did he complain about?After he bought a house,
他在买了房子之后，对什么事情有很多抱怨
？What did he do in the end?
最后他做了什么
？My old friend Harrison had lived in the Mediterranean for many years before he returned to England.He had often dreamed of retiring in England and had planned to settle down in the country. He had no sooner returned than he bought a house and went to live there. Almost immediately, he began to complain about the weather. For even though it was still summer, it rained continually, and it was often bitterly cold.After so many years of sunshine, Harrison got a shock. He acted as if he had never lived in England before. In the end, it was more than he could bear. He had hardly had time to settle down when he sold the house and left the country. The dream he had had for so many years ended there. Harrison had thought of everything.Except the weather.
Well, have you enjoyed the story? I hope you have. Well, I have. All right, now let me remind you of those questions. 现在呢，我们要回过头来看看那些问题，看看大家能否回答。
Where had Harrison spent many years before he returned to England?
Harrison 在回到英国之前，在哪儿住了多年？
He had spent many years in the Mediterranean before he returned to England.
他在回到英国之前呢，在地中海地区住了多年。
What did he complain about after he bought a house?
他买了房子以后，又对什么抱怨呢
？He complained about the weather. For even though it was summer,It was bitterly cold, and it rained continually.
他在买了房子以后抱怨天气，因为即使在夏天，也不停地下雨，而且呢冷得刺骨。
What did he do in the end?
最后他做了什么事儿
？He sold the house and left England.
最后呢，他把房子卖了。离开了英国。All
right, so much for the questions.
Now, let's look at some language points in the lesson. Harrison had lived in the Mediterranean for many years before he returned to England.
Harrison 在回到英国之前在地中海地区住了多年。
The Mediterranean 在这里的意思是 The Mediterranean area,
地中海地区。好，我们看下一个原点。
He had often dreamed of retiring in England and had planned to settle down in the country.
过去呢，他常梦想着退休以后回到英国，并且打算在乡间定居下来。
Dream of
是梦想的什么事情，后面呢要跟动名词
retiring。Settle down
意思是安顿。我们来看看 settle down 的几个例句。
She settled herself down in a chair with a cup of tea.
她拿了杯茶，舒舒服服地在椅子里坐了下来。
The situation has settled down.
这里的意思是局势已经平静下来，那么 settle down 在这里的意思是平静下来。好，我们再看下一个语言点。
Almost immediately he began to complain about the weather, for even though it was still summer, it rained continually and it was often bitterly cold.
紧接着他就开始抱怨起天气来，因为即使是夏天，那也是雨下个不停，而且呢，冷得厉害。
For
在这里是连词，它用来做解释，解释前面的部分，相当于因为，但是 for 不能够用在句子的开头。
Continually
意思是不停的。那么下面我们来看一看continually 和 continuously 这两个词的一些区别。
They quarreled continually.
他们不断的吵架。
Continually
是指频率很高的。
They have quarreled continuously for more than an hour.
他们已经连续不停地吵了一个多小时。从这两个例句中我们可以看出来 continuously 的意思呢是连续不断的。好，我们再看下一个原点。
After so many years of sunshine, Harrison got a shock.
Harrison 在阳光下生活了那么多年，对此呢感到吃惊。
shock
这个词的意思是吃惊、震惊。那么我们以前学过 surprise 也是惊奇、吃惊。那么有什么区别呢？我们来看看例句。
The news of her death was a shock to me.
她去世的消息使我吃了一惊。
Your letter came as a surprise.
你的来信使我很惊喜。从这两个例句中我们可以看出 shock 和 surprise 它们的含义有所不同。 shock 一般是指震惊，是指一种令人不安的事情。 surprise 是一种惊喜。好，下面我们再看下一个原点。
He acted as if he had never lived in England before.
他的举动就好像他从未在英国生活过。
As if
等于 as though， 意思是好像怎么样，仿佛怎么样。 用 as if 或者 as though 后面呢要用虚拟语气。She looked at me as if I were a stranger.
她看我的样子好像我就是个陌生人一样。那么这里的 as if I were a stranger 是虚拟语气的表示方法。be 动词用 were 而不用 am 或者 was。也就是说我并非陌生人，这是一种虚拟的说法。
It looked as though it were going to rain.
看起来就好像要下雨似的。
As though 和 as if 意思是一样，
就好像怎么样。
As though it were going to rain
也是虚拟语气的说法，看起来像是要下雨，但实际上并没有下雨。那么 be 动词 were。好，我们再看下个语言点。
It was more than he could bear.
他实在忍受不了了。
More than he could bear
的意思是超出了他能忍受的程度。那么我们再看看 more than 这个结构的用法。
My gratitude is more than I can express in words.
意思是我的感激之情并非言辞所能表达，也就是说超过了我能用言辞表达的程度。语言点我们就讲到这儿，接下来我们要看看本课中的关键句型。
He had no sooner returned than he bought a house and went to live there.
他刚刚一回到英国就买了一幢房子住了进去。
No sooner than
这个结构表示一怎么样就怎么样，相当于
as soon as。
这句话也可以用 as soon as 来表达。
As soon as he returned, he bought a house and went to live there.
但是用了 no sooner than 这一结构就要注意时态的变化。在 no sooner 这一部分要用过去完成时态 had returned， than 后面连接的部分呢要用过去式 bought。 好，我们再看几个例句。
I had no sooner entered the room than the telephone rang。
我刚一进屋子电话铃就响了。在这个结构中No sooner 要跟过去完成时 had entered 连用， than 后面跟的是过去式 rang。 那么 no sooner 这个结构， no sooner than 这个结构也可以把它放到句首，但是放到句首呢过去完成时态助动词 had 要提前。
No sooner had I entered the room than the telephone rang.
在这一课中还出现了一个结构跟 no sooner than 意思差不多，这就是 hardly when。 用法上和 no sooner than 结构一样， hardly 这个部分要跟过去完成时态， when后面要用过去式。
He had hardly had time to settle down when he sold the house.
他刚刚安顿下来就把房子给卖了。
I had hardly known him well enough when he began to greet me like an old friend.
我还没怎么认识他呢，他就开始像老朋友一样跟我打招呼。这里 hardly 部分要用过去完成时态 had known， when 后面跟过去时 began。 同样 hardly when 这个结构也可以放到句首，放到句首的时候助动词 had 要提前。
Hardly had I known him well enough when he began to greet me like an old friend.
好，关键句型我们就讲到这儿。最后呢，我想就课文的话题再说一两点。大家知道英国人特别爱谈天气，在路上跟陌生人搭话也是从谈天气开始。英国人已经对天气形成了一种特有的幽默感。有一个例子可以说明，在我们传统中的印象，一个英国的绅士总是带着一把雨伞。A typical image of an English gentleman is one who always carries an umbrella. 另外有一点呢，就是 culture shock, 文化震惊，说的是一个人从一个文化到另一种文化中所体验到的种种不适应而引起的一种惊诧感。那么在这个故事中， Harrison 所体验到的是一种 reversed culture shock, 是一种反过来的文化震惊。因为他本是英国人，在国外住了多年以后，回到自己的文化中反倒感到不适应了。 OK, that's it for today's lesson. See you next time.